Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and today I'm gonna try to recycle can. I already prepared my card, what I did. I opened the can, I took off the top and bottom and put it here in the middle so I do have piece like this. Then I took box, it can be cereal box from any chocolate maybe or some cookies maybe. And I glued the piece of can to that box, to that cereale box. I used the double-sided tape and I've got here my card. I also prepared two other cards. They are always 1/4 inch bigger than is this base. So in the end I should have this layout like frames around when I will have decorated full this metal piece. So I wanted to do something with my inks. I've got here those wonderful inks from Tim Holtz, from Ranger. But today I received what I found on Amazon, collection of drawing inks, and they are alcohol inks as well. It's beautiful collection of inks. The box looks like this. And I found it on Amazon. I will put all information about all products I'm gonna use to that description box below. So this I found on Amazon and there is 20 colors, five colors, it's only white, four colors are blue. This is peacock blue, which is really beautiful blue, but it's kind of mix between blue and green, but beautiful one. So I've got here those inks and I think I'm gonna try them today. I've got here my isopropanol, bottle of isopropanol, and what I'm gonna do, first I'm gonna put some inks on that metal. So I did watch many videos last few days from Tim Holtz, from Jennifer McGuire ink, and I tried many different techniques and I love them all. But I think you always will have to find your own style, what works for you. So it's same like with paper. More you will try, more experiences you will have, how that ink works and what that ink can do for you, which kind of magics. And I really love those inks, they are wonderful and it's so fun to create with them. It's kind of magic what how they move and what colors they can do. So what I'm gonna do first, I'm gonna put here a little bit more of that blue and I'm gonna add there a few more inks. I'm using that isopropanol for moving my inks a little bit. So here I saw brown color. I'm gonna give it a try. What kind of brown is this one? Normally I would use Tim Holtz Caramel, which is my favorite, total favorite, I can say. So these drawing inks are really beautiful. I like those bright colors and I'm gonna add there, this is yellow, lemon yellow, and this is yellow. I'm gonna try this yellow because that blue, it's kind of dry now, so maybe. I know I'm not placing them all of them at once. That's what I said, that you have to find your own technique, what you will like to do. Not sure if I should spray it. I'm gonna spray it just a little bit here. And I'm gonna use my straw. And maybe put a little bit more of that brown here. I'm wondering what that will do. Here it's kind of dry, so I'm gonna try to spray it a little bit more with that isopropanol that's moving my ink. This is, by the way, perfect for smokers. You will have to, you know, You'll have to. Oh, blow that ink, so it's perfect for smokers. I'm gonna keep it like this. It's kind of mess right now. It is. But I would like to use my stamps and do some stamping. So what I'm gonna do next, I'm gonna clean my table, clear my table, clean my table. And I will show you what I did, how mix, how I mixed. I mixed leftover of my hand sanitizer with a little bit of Rangers alcohol ink, that indigo. I went, what is that right word? I went off with my isopropanol, and I was thinking what I can use instead of isopropanol. And of course, that hand sanitizer has also alcohol inside, so I was thinking I'm gonna use that. So when I mix that with my alcohol ink, it make that gel, colored gel. So then I just place it on my stamp like this. It's not so many inside. So I just wipe it on my background stamp like this. And then I tried to stamp with it, and it actually made beautiful stamping. On background stamps, it works really well. I try to stamp also with, with sayings and with numbers and with some images. It wasn't as good as with background stamps. I really like that soft stamping here, and it's made just with that hand sanitizer. And a little bit of that indigo blue alcohol ink. So I'm gonna use it here on this corner as well. Like this. I'm gonna let it dry a little bit, and I've got here my envelope where I am stamping those leftovers, and hopefully later I will do some art with this envelope as well. So I'm gonna use this here. It's kind of crazy, but I don't mind too much. I like how it lift up a little bit of that ink I've got already there. So I'm gonna clean my stamp because I don't want to ruin my stamp. And I really love to experiment with those inks. When I saw Tim Holtz demos, he's got amazing demos. He shows so many techniques. So I was like, oh, I have to try everything. And it's awesome. It's awesome to work with those inks. It's like magic when they move and what you can do with them. And it's great because I can use them on those cans. So right now I'm gonna use my heating tool, as I don't have here the hair dryer. So I'm gonna very carefully use that heating tool because I've been working with isopropanol and with that hand sanitizer. Both of them has alcohol inside, and I don't want to blow it here if I will warm it. It's metal, so it can get too hot. So I'm gonna be very careful with that drying. You always have to think about steps you do. Do not hurt yourself, do not blow up your home. You always have to be careful, you have to think what you do. So a little bit more. Here I can see, and remember, if you will use heating tool on metal can will get warm. So be always careful with that. Do not touch it too fast because it will be hot. But I think it's same. Like you have to think how to use scissors. Do not cut yourself. How to use paper. Do not make paper cuts. I think I've got all that piece dry. Yeah, it looks good right now. So what I'm gonna do next. I've got here alcohol lift ink. And I saw Tim Holtz do amazing things with that. So I'm gonna just show you what I learned from those demos. If you didn't see that, link will be down below to Tim Holtz blog, where you can see all those amazing techniques he show. So I'm gonna first use this stamp. This is from Glitch, from that bigger one. This is Glitch number C, Charlie M, I have no idea, S, Sierra probably, 403, Glitch. M like mama, probably. Or, yeah, mama. Or mummy, or, I don't know. I'm gonna stamp with that alcohol lift ink right here. And I'm gonna take my envelope again. I'm gonna let it dry. I'm gonna take my envelope again and stamp here. It's gonna be a very crazy envelope. But look at that. Look how beautifully it takes that ink from your background, and you can stamp many times after you lift up that ink. I will clean my stamps later. And I'm gonna do it one more time with this lift ink, this time on this side, somewhere here. Hopefully. And I'm gonna place it right here. Look how beautiful it takes those inks. So I will need to be prepared next time with some tacks, because it will be gorgeous on tacks. And now that's what I learned from Tim Holtz. I've got here dry napkin. Just normal paper napkin, and I'm gonna lift those inks from those stamped images just with dabbing until the dabbing process. You just need to dab to lift up that ink. And I think I can do it straight away right here as well. Just dab with clear paper towel or napkin or maybe toilet paper, anything what will lift up that ink. I still have there something. Yeah, still. I'm gonna take clean. A little bit more. And very carefully, I'm gonna clean that image. So I've got background like this, with stamping and with that lift ink. And now what I'm gonna do, I've got here beautiful embossing folder from Daris. It's this compass. So I'm gonna emboss this part with this compass. I'm gonna try to move that embossing folder the way that I can follow the circle I just lift up with that stamp. So I get this way, and I'm gonna emboss it. So you do have this embossed effect here, and I'm gonna continue to do some magics. So what I will do next, I'm gonna a little bit sand those embossed parts, not too much. I don't wanna go to with that sanding block to, you know, to those other pieces. I just wanna sand a little bit those embossed parts. I'm gonna rather use this nail file to make it, you know, more soft, more on the pieces I wanna sand a little bit from that ink, like this. Gonna take clean paper napkin, and now I'm gonna do some rusty effect, because I do love rust. I do love that rusty effect. I prepared for myself those two paints. These are from Ranger distress paint. This is vintage photo distress paint, and this is broken china. I tried them many times in the past, and they do amazing effect. If you wanna do flat rusty effect, if you don't need that texture, you can go just with those paints, and very carefully to add those paints to your art. I'm gonna give it a try to be really careful and very soft with that dabbing, to make sure I will be mostly on that embossed area, but maybe somewhere, yeah, like here. I'm not too soft. I have to be really, really soft. To add there that dabbing, mostly just on those embossed areas. And the truth is that when you work with metal piece, especially those cans, they like to get a little bit curly. So it's not flat area where you need to dab. So first I'm going with this vintage photo. And those edges I will do a little bit more, especially corners. I will go a little bit heavy with that ink, or with that paint. Also, please remember, if you work with a metal piece, the edges can be sharp. So be careful how you handle those cans, because those corners are very sharp. You can make really bad cuts in your hand. I've been working with metal for many years. I've been welder, so been learning a lot. How badly you can hurt yourself with metal. So always be careful. Always think about moving your hands, about moving your fingers around the edges. But as I said, it's same like with paper. If you will be not careful with paper, you can cut your fingers pretty badly as well. So it's always same. I think I don't have to tell you. We are adults, we should know, right? And in those corners, I guess I would like to have it a little bit more. This, and I'm gonna use my heating tool to dry it. Oh, postman came. I think I should go there because it sounds very heavy. Here in those corners, I'm gonna use a little bit more right now when it's hot, hot. I'm not gonna touch it with my fingers, but I'm gonna add there a little bit more. Good. And now I'm gonna use that blue broken china. And with that broken china, I will try to add there some beautiful rusty patina on those edges and here and there on those embossed parts. I'm not going to add there too much of that blue, just very light coats of that broken china. And if I will don't like it, I will go back again with that vintage photo to make that effect the way I want it. So I think here I will go a little bit more. Not here. And over it with that blue. I'm gonna use that blue. And with that blue, just just like this. Here I think I'm gonna add there a little bit more that vintage photo because I dab it with my finger too much. That wasn't good. So always you can make layers and layers until you will be satisfied with that result. So I've got that base. And before I will add it to my card. Card here. I'm gonna prepare pieces. I would like to get there. I've got here this wooden piece. This is from a Sacrafter shop. I bought it long time ago, like really long time ago. And then I forgot that I have it. So I never used my wooden pieces. I'm gonna go with that vintage photo on the edges. I don't wanna go too much into those words, because I know myself, I will fill it with color, and then nothing will be seen. There will be no word anymore. Not even one. So I've got there that vintage photo, and now I'm gonna try with the broken china. First I will dry it, because I don't wanna mix those colors together. So I'm gonna dry it with my heating tool. This, and now I'm gonna give it a try with that broken china. Go on the edges, not on my fingers. Yeah, I am on my fingers, just on those edges, and maybe my nails. Yeah, that's cool. Like patina. Here it was too much, so I'm gonna just, this is tip from Tim Holtz as well, when it's too much, just take it off with your fingers, make it a little bit softer with your fingers. He does have amazing tips. I will tell you, go to have a look, really go to have a look. So I would like to add this enjoy the journey somewhere here, and I would like to have there a little bit more. I've got here beautiful dye from Marianne Design. Here is the name, Marianne Design, and here is the number of the die, COL1418. This is the number of that die, and the die, it's this one. Beautiful numbers, really amazing numbers. So I've got here, oops, I've got here number 9 and number 6, but I'm gonna use them 66. Road 66 in America, wonderful road, beautiful road. It was very famous. I'm not sure if is it still famous, if is it still in use. I think it was shorted a little bit, but a while ago it was longer road, but it's still very long. It's, I think, 3,000, nearly 4,000 kilometers long. So this is the die I'm gonna use to create that number 66, and I've got here also double. This is acrylic paint from Ranger as well. This is copper. So first I'm gonna prepare for myself this one. I'm gonna dab that copper to those two numbers. Need to hold it a little bit. So I'm gonna dab that copper in there. One, move yourself, and two, and we will try to make it look vintage, like really vintage, beautiful vintage. Oh, too much paint. I'm gonna dry it with my heating tool again, and then I will use again that vintage photo and broken china, those paints, just on edges, and I will try to make that number look rusty and worn. But first I have to let it dry, heat, like bake that color into that can. It will hold much better. Still hot, so don't want to touch it too fast. I'm gonna take that vintage photo. Yeah, it's good now. I'm gonna take that vintage photo, and with that vintage photo, I'm gonna add a little bit of color around the edges. Sorry for my hands, they will be a little bit painted as well. So not on all that surface, just on the edges. And same I'm gonna do then with that broken china. But with that rusty, with that vintage photo, I'm going up like a little bit more. Here I totally covered that. Yeah, I'm gonna leave it there. I need to let it dry again, so I'm gonna use my heating tool to speed it up a little bit. And if you will notice, I'm not sure if you can see that, I'm gonna try to take the other number. I'm gonna take this other number to my tweezers and I will try to show you that copper paint, when I use that heating tool, I hope you can see those bubbles. Copper paint with that vintage photo makes beautiful bubbles, which will also make that rusty effect, that worn effect, much more visible, much more stronger. So I'm gonna let it dry. And I'm gonna use that broken china on those edges. And really just those edges a little bit. And a little bit in that middle, just like this. And not sure how I will add it here. Yeah, I guess just like this, just a little bit, not too much. And a little bit on the top, where are those bubbles? Not too much, very softly. And where is too many, try to wipe it off. Yes, I think I can live with this. 99, not 99, 66, upside down, this one, not 99, that's Brooklyn 99, do you watch that series? Oh, that's so amazing. So first what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take my smaller card, here I've got that last one, which will be like total background. I'm gonna take this smaller card. Before I will put this on my second card, I'm gonna fix that enjoy the journey, because I'm gonna use those small brats with short legs. I'm not sure how to call those ends, I guess it's leg, and I lost my brat, so I'm gonna punch the hole where I want to fix that enjoy the journey, I think. Here and here, somewhere here, enjoy the journey, yeah, probably, to make it straight with this edge, this way, I guess. So I'm gonna punch the hole here and here. And I'm gonna use this regular gel gloss, glossy gel. It's mixed medium gel. It dries clear. So I'm gonna use it to glue the piece on my can. It doesn't dry straight away. It needs to some time to dry. But I wanna fix it there like permanently. So I'm gonna use that gel, and here I'm gonna fix it with those brats. one and other one. And I'm gonna use the same gel to fix my numbers, to glue those numbers on that metal piece. Like this. So now I'm gonna use that gel to glue those 6-6 numbers. You can use the, what is it? The glue, the super glue. It will hold on the metal as well. Super glue, it's really good glue to use it when you need to glue something really fast and strong. The super glue, it's good solution. I don't have it right here, so I'm gonna use this acrylic gel. And super glue has mostly that fine tip on the end, so it's good to use it. Here we will have to wait until it will dry. It takes time to dry, but it holds really well. I have used it on my first card I made, or using can to glue the number. Oops, see, it needs some time to dry. Maybe I should glue it like last thing. I have used that glue for gluing number 7 on this card. This card I created before. I tried to take a video, but unfortunately my camera just screw up. So I don't have video for this one. Hopefully this video will go well and you will see what I'm creating here. I really love to use those alcohol inks and create. And mostly I do love to recycle my cans or my son's cans, because they are from their energy drinks. So now I'm gonna make holes in all four corners, and I will fix there those paper fasteners. They are with bigger head. But that I wanted to do together with the card. See? So I'm gonna use tacky glue. I'm gonna glue this on my paper. And because here at that background, it's that cereal box or a pizza box. I'm not sure what was that. BBQ something. BBQ ribs. Yeah, we had BBQ ribs. By the way, very tasty. We found them in Lidl. Really tasty. Yummy. Been cooking with my son. That was very funny. My son is better in kitchen than I am, because he likes to do that. I don't like to cook. It's just because I had to cook, you know, for 25 years. I had to cook every day and I just don't like it now. I will rather recycle their cans, I guess. It's together. Now I can make holes in all four corners. Here. And here, come on. And I'm gonna put those fasteners, those bigger paper fasteners here, and fix it together. Like this. And here. Fastener. Press it down. I think this one I fixed really bad way. Not good way. Because it's moving. So I'm glad I placed that acrylic gel. Hopefully that will fix it all. And here I'm gonna take this last card. I'm gonna put the glue here, and like a last touch on this piece, it will be again vintage photo and broken china painting. And I'm gonna a little bit make rusty these fasteners from that head of these fasteners. Gonna place it here, press it down, glue yourself properly. Sit down, and like last touch will be again vintage photo, and I'm gonna just dab dab on those heads. And once it will dry, and this I'm gonna let it dry on the air, so once it will dry I will add there a little bit of that broken china, and that will be it. So this is my creation for today, using alcohol inks, using distress paint, using gel, all what I have used, including those dies and embossing folder. I will put names down below. I will don't put their links where you can buy it, because you know it's everywhere different. You can find a really good deal in your local shop or on eBay or on Amazon. So I will put their names with numbers if I know, so you can, you know, copy that to your Google search and have a look if somewhere in your area you will find those products if you are interested. So this is my sharing for today. Sorry for my hand. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you have some idea what to do. Go to have a look to Tim Holtz and Jennifer McGuire Inc. What they do with alcohol inks. That's really amazing. That's something totally awesome. These are my creations, my vintage postcards, metal postcards. This is how they look from other side. And thank you so much for visiting me today. Have a wonderful day. Oh, do not touch it too fast, because then you will get you will get that color on your hand. So have a wonderful day. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.